When Gene first came up with the idea for Star Trek, he had about 12 pages, and he shoved them across the desk at me and said, read this and tell me what you think. And I took it home, and I really liked it, and I came back and I said, who's going to play Spock?
You had an interest in a character right off.
Right away, yeah.
They produced a pilot called The Cage.
Check the circuit.
All operating, sir.
Confine the screen, then.
It begins on the bridge of a recognizable Starship Enterprise, commanded by Captain Christopher Pike, played by the late Jeff Hunter.
Still something out there.
I put a woman second in command of our starship.
All decks are ready, sir.
And I had written in another character who wasn't even human.
Spock here.
An alien who looked like Satan himself, complete with pointy ears.
Brains three times the size of ours. If we start buzzing about down there, we're liable to find their mental power is so great, they could reach out and swat this ship as over a fly.
It's Captain Pike they've got.
It was about the captain being captured by aliens and placed into a cage, like an animal cage. And then these aliens were able to play tricks with his mind, put him in these other alternate realities, while at the same time he was actually still trapped in the cage.
But we're not here, neither of us. We're in a menagerie, a cage.
A curious species.
My father was making statements back then that you can't just cage up a human and trick them into thinking that they've got freedom. People want freedom. People want the freedom to think, to move, to act, to do whatever they want.